song from Delta Squid, and you're listening to Sinvicta on SS Radio.
Hello, this is Sparse Vector, the creator of Super Amazing Wagon Adventure, and you're listening to Sinvicta on SS Radio.
Hey, this is Zettel, creator of Imba League and Husky Madness, and you are listening to Sinvicta on SS Radio.
This is Chan Man B of Wednesday Night Sprites and Climbing the Ladder, and you're listening to Sinvicta on SS Radio.
Yo, it's Tempo from IBD Gaming, and you are tuned in to my brother Sinvicta on SS Radio.
Hello, this is Nick Axavranish from Major League Gaming, and you're listening to Sinvicta on SS Radio.
What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Boogie2988 here, and you're listening to my good friend Sinvicta on SS Radio.
Live on Twitch TV and on the VODs here on YouTube.com, it's SS Radio! 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 And now, here's your host, Sinvicta. What is up? What is going on? Everyone out there on the interwebs and internets, it is SS Radio number 109 coming at you, not live. Well, it's live for me, but it's going to be in the past for you all. So let me talk about what's been going on for the past couple of days now on the Twitch channel and the reason why you're hearing this on SS Radio number 109 on YouTube, not on SS Radio number 109. Well, I guess it is kind of on SS Radio number 109, but more importantly on the YouTube channel and not on the Twitch TV channel. So basically what happened is that my upload speed has been complete garbage for the past 36 hours now. I've been unable to stream. I was able to stream early this morning, but then the connection died off again. And to sum it all up, Comcast, who is my ISP, has to come out here on Wednesday to try to address the problem. I'm going to attempt to address it on my own terms by swapping out my router for a different router that I can maybe use my VPN on, because the current one that I have does not support a VPN, and maybe get things rectified until Wednesday. I'm not sure. Obviously, this is not the way that I wanted to do this, especially with it being a 2014 year in review show, that sort of thing. But I also do not want to miss any more broadcasting opportunities, especially when it comes to something as important as SS Radio. Again, remember, SS Radio happens every single Sunday, the first Sunday of every month here in the year 2015. I'm looking forward to it. So, without any further ado, let's get right on to the topics. This is how we do it on SS Radio. I count back from 3, 2, 1, and then show you topics. So, 3, 2, 1, there we are, the topics for tonight's SS Radio. I'm not going to be doing a commercial break, obviously, or a mid-show break, because there's really no reason for me to do that. I'm going to be talking about my 2014 year in review, kind of give you my overall impersonations, impressions. I don't know what impersonations I can do. I might be able to do Husky, but I don't know. I'm not a very good impressionist. But my 2014 year in review, going to be also covering my favorite 2014 moments that happened this past year, as well as share with you all something that has been much requested on the Twitch channel, along with on YouTube as well. People wanted my picks for the game of the year, my version of the game of the year. I'm not going to be giving awards or anything like that. I'll say a couple of nominations and then give you all my overall game of the year. I think it's going to be pretty obvious which one it is, but we'll get to that in the first half of the show. And then in the second half of the show, I say halves even though we're not splitting it up. Hey, it's just force of habit by now. I'm going to be going over my 2015 preview, my expectations, my goals here in the new year, and wrapping it all up with not chat Q&A, because you currently can't talk to me live unless you were sitting with me. I mean, if you all were here right now, that I don't think my room would not be big enough. I mean, I can't fit 13 people, let alone 13,000 of you from YouTube and from the internet in here. I think it might be a little bit cozy, a little bit more cozy than what I would like. So, yeah, I mean, I like you. I like all of you. But I'm not saying I'd want to be stuck in the same room with all of you at the same exact time. That would be a little bit of invasion of my personal bubble space sort of thing. So enough about that. Right back up to the top. Let's go ahead and get right to it. My 2014 year in review. It was the biggest year by far for not only my content, but as well as mentally speaking, I've been better with the way that the year ended. We won't be dwelling on the negatives, but obviously, you know, losing both grandpas on one on each side of the family kind of put a damper on the end of the year of what was otherwise a very fantastic year. We've seen enormous growth in the YouTube channel as well as the Twitch channel. I was able to become a Twitch TV partner this year, which was, of course, one of the biggest things that ever happened for me, because it not only does it solidify that, you know, what I'm trying to accomplish here, the community that I'm trying to build, is now going to be possible and going to be able to support me directly, even though it's not very much money, mind you, but it's still helping me out greatly. And it makes me appreciate having what it's like to have to go through the grind, if you will, starting from the ground up and then moving on up to, you know, the promised land of maybe financial independence. I don't know. Again, that's the hope and goals, but we're not going to get ahead of ourselves. So losing both of my grandpas was definitely a big blow mentally for our family. It came at a time of great happiness. Of course, with BlizzCon 2014, I was at a Metallica concert for the first time in a long time. Caught, you know, one of Rob's bass picks, which was also unbelievable. Only to then have to, you know, go to my Chinese grandfather's funeral all the way across the country, and then having another funeral happening for my other grandfather. This is actually my great grandfather who passed away less than 2 weeks later. So that was a very bad time for our family, but we are strong and we are persevering past that. Now, going on to the more positive things, again, like I said, I was able to attain my Twitch TV partnership, meaning that I'm allowed to monetize ads and doing ad breaks, that sort of thing. It's not a lot of money. A lot of people do make a lot of money on Twitch, enough to support themselves and their family. Of course, everyone knows I'm a huge fan of Lethal Frag, who is my... It's hard for me to call Frag my inspiration because I didn't know who Frag was until about a year and a half. It was about, I'd say, a year and a half ago when I caught him during the 2 year live stream challenge. He's not an inspiration, but he's definitely someone that I aspire to be. Let's put it that way. I would define inspiration as being something that I had a premonition about before trying something like that. Let's put it that way. Like, I could call Frag an inspiration if I knew of Frag from the very beginning and then aspired to be him, but I didn't. But it's very weird and funny in a way that Lethal Frag and I have so similar mentalities when we're talking about new media. Obviously, he's way more accelerated for what he does because he is able to provide for his family and do this full-time, which is amazing. And that is definitely something that I aspire to be. But not meeting Lethal Frag, being able to talk to Lethal Frag was, you know, that was great. That was great. And then all that goes back into me becoming a Twitch TV partner, Twitch allowing me to have paid subscribers. People can subscribe if they want to directly contribute to me and support me. It's great. Of course, I've always had donations. And that's also something that I don't normally plug. Again, the only time I've ever plugged for donations was during the Kickstarter stream. And that is really it. I don't really like soliciting. Again, the catchphrase that I will borrow from Frag is donations are never solicited but always appreciated, and that holds true to subscriptions as well. Although more recently I've begrudgingly started to plug the subs more and more because that is a very significant part of my livelihood. I mean, again, we're talking about the amount of money between, and this is not something that I'm afraid to share. Contractually, I'm not able to go into specifics, but one thing I will say is that the combined total of my paychecks from Twitch TV and from YouTube is less than $500 every 45 days. And that will give you a little bit of a glimpse of how difficult it is to start up in new media. And the reason why I'm telling you all this is not because I'm not panhandling or looking for sympathy or anything like that, for some sort of extra financial support. I'm not doing that. The reason why I don't mind sharing that kind of information is because I do get a lot of questions from fans wanting to start up their own channel. A lot of them talk about the financial side, and it's always the same answer. What I tell people now is what I've told people since I started doing this, which is that you can cannot go into this industry with financial stability in mind. You can't do it. The only reason why I am able to do it was because I worked for an IT company down here, and I managed the office and did repairs for about 2 years. It was just over 2 years, and I've saved up over those 2 years so I could quit and do this full time, and living only on savings, because I knew that I wasn't going to bring any money in. And making money on the internet is never a guarantee, especially in new media. Less than 1% of the people who try or maybe get a shot to make even a single cent off it, let alone a paycheck worthy enough of paying bills and that sort of thing, which, of course, I'm still not. The paycheck, it pays for a couple bills, but the biggest thing is the reason why I'm able to do this as my job is because I simply just don't have a lot of bills, thanks to my living situation right now, which, again, is layman's terms for I live with one of my parents, helping my dad out and dealing with his health issues, that sort of thing. But that's beside the point. Adding Twitch to my repertoire as far as another source of revenue was big. It was something that I applied for on a whim, and I was completely flabbergasted that when I got an email from the Twitch TV rep who approved my application and said because of the traffic that I pull in on YouTube, I was able to be approved. And that's not something that they do for everybody. Which again, all that goes to, of course, all this comes back to full circle thanking Husky, because Husky is the person who makes all of this possible. And I will never, ever forget that. Again, it's something I've talked about on and on, you know, yeah, cue the bromance music, blah, blah, blah. Look, Husky's basically my brother. I mean, he helped me get started, and he continues to help me. Without Husky, none of Sinvicta would not be here. I know for a fact that I would not be where I am right now. And I'm not saying that I've made it. I'm not saying that I'm someone who is a staple of the new media community, because I can't even, you know, I can't support myself right now, but I'm on the way. That was the most exciting bit for me, becoming a Twitch TV partner, was, hey, now I have two sources of income. I can actually do streaming without having feel like I'm not really accomplishing anything towards my new media career, and still do YouTube. You know, so that was the big thing. That was a big turning point, a big key point for me in 2014, was attaining the right, the privilege to become a Twitch TV partner and get paid for streaming. And of course, then I adjusted my schedule. I started doing the daily streams. We introduced Tryhard Thursday. Before that, it was Throwdown Thursday with Hearthstone, and of course Bronze Age Hero streams, which was the most popular thing ever, and then, you know, evolving into other shows like Tryhard Thursday, Friday Night Fan Fights, the Saturday Series Smackdown, Steamy Sundays, and then regressing back a bit because of the fact that I just wasn't enjoying them anymore, even though I know a lot of people are still keen on both of those shows. They went in a direction that I was not intending, and again whenever I stop enjoying something is when I just stopped doing it, period. And I've always been like that. I'm never a half in, half out sort of person. It's never black. It's never gray for me. It's either black or white. I'm either 100% in or I'm either 100% out. And that doesn't work for everyone, but it works for me. So other than that, other than BlizzCon, of course, meeting all the fans of BlizzCon, that was great. Getting to see Husky and Crendor and all my friends from LA again was great. Of course, Crendor, he doesn't live in LA, he lives in Chicago, but hey, that's beside the point. And yeah, the Twitch TV partnership was great. I mean, that was phenomenal. YouTube, we saw huge growth on YouTube, which I'm expecting even more growth coming into the year 2015, as we saw at the same sort of growth level, percentage-wise, that we saw in 2014, going into 2015. So I'm really, really looking forward to that. But overall, great year of gaming as well. Many games to get to that I ended up playing, games that I didn't think I would play, but I still played anyway. So some of the games that I'm going to be talking about as well as we go into the topic number two of my favorite moments, the best 2014 moments of this past year. Some of the games that I might mention, especially leading into the third topic, may not necessarily be games that came out this year or this past year in the year 2014, but I still played them. So that's where I kind of differentiate between release dates and when Sinvicta actually plays them, because, like, as everyone knows, I'm pretty infamous in finding games that were popular a while ago and then starting to play them now. So forgive me for that. I'm going to be giving you impressions of games that I actually played this past year rather than maybe some of those who did not. which did not release in the past year. So that being said, moving on to topic number two, talking about my favorite 2014 moments. By far, number one, bar none, was when Lethal Frag hosted me for the 24-hour Kickstarter stream to support the second half of our album. Of course, I can't. That's number one. That ranks up there. That was unbelievable for me. And this is something I've talked about before, but in case if you are new to Sinvicta, or if you're new to any of my content in general, especially on Twitch, you will not have known that I have been, my goal was to always break 1,000 concurrent viewers. I thought that that would never, ever be possible for me when I started doing Twitch. I was lucky to get maybe 5 viewers, maybe, you know, and 3 of those are like my real life friends. I'm like, hey, if you want to see me play WoW for a couple hours, how fun could that be? Tune here, you know, that sort of thing, or, you know, your family members or whatever. That's how I expected this to go. So after doing the Bronze League Hero stuff this year and almost getting to 1,000 viewers, concurrent viewers, during the Bronze League Heroes 12-hour live stream, which is how a majority of the people who still follow me to this day on Twitch came about knowing who I was, thanks to Husky plugging the 12-hour Bronze League Heroes stream that I did way, way, way back in the day. The closest we got was 865 viewers total. I remember watching that number and thinking, oh my goodness, I can't believe there is literally hundreds and hundreds of people watching me right now. So I said, from that point on, my goal is to break 1,000. Never came close again, ever. In the year that I've been streaming on Twitch, we never even came close to 865 viewers, let alone 1,000 viewers. So in comes the amazing and true aspiration of mine, Lethal Frag, someone who I've been a fan of many, many years now. Not many, many years, but a year and a half, let's put it that way. But someone who I definitely aspire to be. I had no idea that Frag knew about the Kickstarter, and he ended up hosting me. Now, what that means, for those of you who are not privy to Twitch TV, a broadcaster can use a host command where they embed whoever they're hosting's channel inside of their channel. So, for example, if I have 100 people watching me and I type /host host Husky, for example, my channel will then kind of drop down, and then Husky's channel will appear still inside of my channel. And the people who are currently watching my channel will get transferred to watching his channel but still stay in a separate chat room. Frag did this when he had 6,700 people watching, and it was early in the morning. Again, I had no idea that this was happening. You can actually find the exact moment on my Twitch channel VODs where Frag's host came in, and all of a sudden I see Lethal Frag is hosting you for 6,677 people, viewers, sorry, not people, viewers. I could not believe it. I was flabbergasted. I was almost brought to tears because it was so special to me that not only was I able to break 1,000 viewers, I was able to smash that, and it was all because of thanks to Lethal Frag, someone who I didn't even know. He knows who I am, but I would have never dreamed in a million years that Frag would have even entertained the idea of hosting me, let alone, you know, plugging, you know, one of my channels or anything like that. Frag even watched read everything about the Kickstarter page. He watched the little intro that I did, and that was truly an honor, and that is why that is my favorite 2014 moment by far. By far the best. That was the best thing ever, especially coming from the downfall mentality-wise that I was experiencing thanks to the deaths of my grandfathers. That was something that turned it around, because I thought, you know, I wasn't emotionally devastated, of course, but whenever you lose a family member, obviously it's not a fun time. So that little turnaround really did perk me up, and, you know, we finished 2014 out with a bang. It was really great. Other best 2014 moments by far was BlizzCon, definitely. Seeing Metallica, catching one of Rob's picks, that was amazing. Going back before that, playing The Binding of Isaac for the very first time, thanks to Lethal Frag, of course. Also got introduced to FTL, also got introduced to Risk of Rain. All those games were amazing, were absolutely amazing. Some lesser of the others, but as you've seen here, we've seen content from all of those games here on the channel. But obviously, the biggest of them was The Binding of Isaac and the Wrath of the Lamb expansion, which I have dubbed Vanilla Isaac, because it's, to me, they're the same game, even though one is an expansion of the other. So I can't really rank those as far as it's hard for me to say like those are my, you know, number one, two, three favorite moments. But outside of the Lethal Frag moment, you know, it was being able to play and get introduced to games that I normally never would have, thanks to Frag. That was special. It was special because I'm not a gamer who branches out all that much. I used to like FPSs. I transitioned to MMOs, and then, you know, now I kind of wrote the roguelike genre is more of my staple than anything. That, and of course, the MOBAs, the Heroes of the Storms and the League of Legends of the world. Not so much Dota anymore, as everyone knows. Other top moments, of course, are going to be we released the album this year in August, something that that was 2 years in the making. I was very, very proud of that, and the album continues to be downloaded every single day by a lot of people, which is very, very cool. I've had a lot of messages, people asking me if they can use them for the YouTube videos, and of course, I always approve that, because that's what I do it for. Now, on that topic, very quickly, before we hop into my Game of the Year pick, one thing I will say is that I've had some people send messages, even on Facebook, asking me if they could repost the song to their YouTube channel but show lyrics and that sort of thing. And that is something that I will not be endorsing. And I would prefer people to not do that, because then what that does is it bypasses the EULA, and that's not the purpose of why I release that for free. I release that for free so people can use it for their creative outlet, not just so they can repost it with lyrics and that sort of thing. And I have had a couple. I haven't officially taken any videos down because none of them exist to my knowledge. But I do know that a couple people were asking, and of course they said, "Oh yeah, you know, we didn't mean any offense. We totally get that. I just wanted to ask if it was possible, because I love your music and this is how I share that." And of course, I definitely appreciate that, but that is not the way that I intend my music to be shared. I would much rather people share it by, you know, using videos, PvP videos, you know, montages, whatever you want. But just reposting the song and putting lyrics to it with credits in the info box is not my, that's not my intention, and that's not my intended use of the sharing the free music. So now that that's out of the way, the album dropping was amazing. BlizzCon, absolutely astounding. I loved it. I absolutely loved it. I got to finally start working hand-in-hand directly with Blizzard, doing the midweek mosh pit with the StarCraft II team. That is awesome indeed. I have even more exciting stuff coming in the way like that for 2015. So being invited by Blizzard to BlizzCon, working directly with Blizzard employees, you know, that sort of thing is something that I would have never, ever dreamed of. Before, you know, if someone told me before I met Husky, Sinvicta, one day you're going to be working with Blizzard, not working for them, but working with them, you're going to be working, you know, doing collaborations with all these big YouTubers, I would have said there's no way. Like, yeah, I can dream that, but there's absolutely no way. I just don't see it happening. You know, it's just, I just make WoW PvP videos, man. Like, I'm not a new media content producer. I just do this for fun sort of thing. But now it's, you know, I've truly found where I want to be. And that's going to go right into topic number three, where I'm going to be going over my Game of the Year. I'm not going to do any build up. Let's just get it out of the way right now. The 2014 Game of the Year for me, for a game that was released this year, is, of course, no surprise, The Binding of Isaac Rebirth. I don't think that's going to shock anybody. The Binding of Isaac Rebirth came out. It was everything that I had dreamt it would be and more. So completely smashed expectations that I had. I cannot believe how amazing the game is. It's not a perfect game, but it is about as close to perfect as possible. Isaac, I'm very thankful, of course, to everyone who's listening to this, and the people. I realize that not every one of my subscribers listens to it, to SS Radio. In fact, SS Radio is the lowest rated show that I have on the channel, but I still do it because I love talking to people. I love talking on a microphone and giving my overall thoughts in a radio sort of presentation. But I'm very, very thankful for everyone allowing me to establish Isaac as a staple of the channel. And again, without Lethal Frag, I would have never played the game because it didn't look like a game that I would enjoy. And since then, of course, Rebirth is now, we just got done releasing episode 41 as of tonight, which is Sunday, the 4th of January, 2015. Excuse me. Muscle memory there. Force of habit, rather. You can expect to see a lot more Isaac content. Now, my other game of the year, and this is going to be a little bit weird, but my other game of the year that I played this year but didn't release this year is The Binding of Isaac Vanilla, because that is what got it all. If I never played Vanilla, I would have never cared about Rebirth, ever. So overall, the 2014 game of the year goes to the Binding of Isaac franchise, period. But for games that were released this year, definitely Rebirth. For games that weren't released this year, but the games I played this year for the very first time, definitely the Binding of Isaac Vanilla, and including the Wrath of the Lamb expansion. Now, other honorable mentions for 2014, of course, Shadow of Mordor, one of the best games I've ever played, ever. I still need to finish it. I'm not interested in putting a Let's Play here on the channel because I don't think people would like that, and that's quite frankly something I don't really want to do, period. But it's a great game to stream, and I definitely am going to be revisiting that very soon. I have to say Infinity Wars, just because Infinity Wars came out this year officially. Well, it's a game that I still play every now and then, albeit not so often anymore, but it is a game that I still play. Path of Exile, of course, officially released this year as well, which is another fantastic game. And if you have not played that, if you not played Path of Exile, you're missing out big time. And I have to, of course, say Hearthstone as well. And I want to thank Blizzard for including me in the closed beta for that, and then going into open beta, and then finally full release of Hearthstone this year. All games that I enjoy, all games that I've played, regardless of when they were released. This is still going to be not your typical game of the year countdown, just because the games that have been out for a while, but games that I haven't played until this past year. And that's kind of how I do that. Now, people are going to say, well, what about Dark Souls 2? Other Steam games that I played, like Audio Surf 2, Street Fighter 4, Risk of Rain, you know, FTL, those sort of things. All those are mentions, but they're not honorable mentions because I quite frankly don't really play them except for FTL. FTL is actually up there. FTL is definitely worthy of a nomination in the honorable mentions. But all that is eclipsed by The Binding of Isaac Rebirth as well as the Isaac franchise. And that is where we are going to be going straight into the 2015 preview, the final topic. Even though I say, I know we have chat Q&A, but let's be honest, I can't even stay connected to the internet right now, thanks to good old Comcast. But what are my upcoming expectations for the year 2015? A lot of people like to throw out the word resolutions. I'm on the other end of the fence about this, about saying, oh, these are my resolutions. Because resolutions, to me, I think they're silly to do, because a lot of people say, well, my resolution is to get in shape, or my resolution is to do better at school, or my resolution is to treat my family better, or try to, you know, reconnect with friends, or, you know, just be a better person. And all those, I mean, they're noble in their own right, but they're not me. I think that if you have to wait for a specific date to start acting like that, I think that you are fooling yourself and there's no way that you are going to commit to it. A lot of people like to eat really unhealthy in the month of December to say, okay, well, I'm just going to make my New Year's resolution to be, I'm just going to get back in shape. And they use that as kind of a crutch and an excuse to treat their bodies terribly. And I'm not going to say that I'm in the best shape. In fact, quite the opposite. I'm in the worst shape of my life. I've never been this unhealthy before. But I'm not going to say, well, that's going to change cold turkey just because of one different day on the calendar. It's not how it works like that with me anyway. I think that if you make resolutions, you're just kind of making excuses for yourself to get away with stuff that you know you probably shouldn't be doing, or probably character flaws that you know you can't change, but you're just going to say, oh, well, I'm just going to make my resolution and get past it that way. That's not how I do things, man. But I will say that I have a couple of anticipations and expectations and goals for the year 2015. My main goal for this new year, for the year 2015, is to continue to put out content on Twitch as well as YouTube, to grow the channel to the point where I can be as financially independent as possible. Now, that is not a realistic goal, and it is not a goal that I'm expecting to hit, but it is a goal nonetheless. In a perfect world, I would love to be able to support myself as well as the people that are dear to me by doing this for a living. And again, I don't know what the future holds, but I do anticipate there'd be an even bigger growth of not only my channel, my here on YouTube, but also my Twitch channel. With the full release of Heroes of the Storm, supposedly dropping sometime this year, that is big time. Big time. Legacy of the Void as well for StarCraft 2 will be dropping. Of course, my StarCraft 2 content has been dipping, gradually to the point where I just don't do it anymore outside of Speedcraft, which also hasn't happened for a while. But 2015 is going to be a very big year for Blizzard titles. Now, non-Blizzard titles, you're talking about the PC release of Grand Theft Auto 5, which is something that I am actually interested in, but not really something that I've been gnawing chomping at the bits, if you will. Of course, the Binding of Isaac Rebirth DLC, which is going to be coming out this year as well, as already confirmed by Edmund and the team who work on the Binding of Isaac. That, of course, is something that I'm highly, highly anticipating. I've heard rumors that there's going to be an updated version of FTL coming out this year, and that is also something I'm very, very interested in checking out. One thing I will say that it kind of changed for me, and this was something that I was going to talk about on stream tonight, but I, alas, could not do that, is the decline of my playing of World of Warcraft. Now, this is a weird time to bring this up, but it is something that I do want to talk about briefly here in the 2015 preview. I still have intentions of continuing the Word of Law series. I know it's been months and months since I put out episode 16, going into episode 17. I started working on episode 17 towards the end of last year and then stopped, just because of the fact I just wasn't playing WoW anymore. I do have enough footage to create the episode, but if I do create the episode, it won't be for a little while. And I know that I have a lot of fans here on YouTube that are still around and who originally discovered me and knew me as Lauder. When I was doing the Protection Warrior PvP videos, and I still love to do that. And that was the whole inspiration for me doing the album as well. I want to continue to do the Word of Law episodes, but I have less of a drive to do them just because I'm not really interested in WoW. I did buy the expansion. I already got Lauder to level 100, I think is the new cap. But I really just don't feel the need to play. I mean, I just don't. I checked out Garrisons. It was great. It was, PvP was hilarious. Gladiator Stance is so broken for Protection Warriors. It's unbelievable. It just feels like a game that for me has not really changed a whole lot. And that is just my, insert your own personal experiences here, but that's just my opinion of it. I've recently canceled my World of Warcraft account subscription because A, there's no point in me paying for something that I'm not playing, and B, I just have no real need to play right now. I have no doubts that I'll return to WoW later on this year. When, I have no idea. I do plan on continuing the Word of Law series. It's just when, I don't know. But to supplement the lack of World of Warcraft PvP videos, here is something that for the first time ever I'm going to be sharing with you all. So for those of you who are longtime Lauder fans, you're going to be very highly interested to know that I have re-uploaded every single episode of the Word of Law to a separate YouTube channel, which I'm not going to be giving out yet because I haven't designed any of the work, I haven't done the thumbnails, none of that stuff. But I will be releasing a second channel. I'm not planning on monetizing any part of it, even if I wanted to, I couldn't, because of all the copyrighted music. I'm going to make sure that they stay up there free of charge for everyone to watch. You don't have to worry about clicking on ads or anything. Just use ad block, as everyone usually does anyway. So I will be uploading and cataloging every single episode of the Word of Law series on a separate channel, not this one. No, Sinvicta's not opening a second channel to make more money. No, I'm not planning on filing for partnership on that other channel because I can't, even if I wanted to, thanks to the music. But I just wanted everyone to know out there how much I appreciate so much support of the Word of Law series, even to this day. It eclipses everything that I've ever done tenfold. You take all the views that I have here on YouTube, which is now approaching 2 million, and if you subtract the amount of views that those were of the Word of Law series, it would be significantly less. You go to warcraftmovies.com and search for Sinvicta or Lauder. You will see how many lifetime views those have, and those are only after 2 years. And you also have to understand that those are videos that have been worked on few and far between. But that is a significant portion of the amount of views that I have attained here on YouTube. And I'm very proud of that. So the whole goal for me to do the second channel is not to file for an extra partnership to make more money. Again, I'm only doing this just to say thanks to everyone who's supported me over the past couple years here on YouTube and putting it back on YouTube off of the Sinvicta 316 channel to go to the other channel for Lauder. That will be released sometime this year. When, I don't know. It's not a top priority project for me, but it's up there. So other than that, other things that I'm looking forward to, being more involved with the Heroes of the Storm community. I don't know if I'm allowed to talk about it yet or not, so I'm not going to. The only thing I'll say is that expect an announcement soon that I will be appearing, if you will, with Blizzard on Heroes of the Storm. That's all I can say. I'm not even sure if I'm allowed to say that, but that's all I'll say without getting too specific. So I'm very much looking forward to that. I'm looking forward to the new season of League of Legends coming out. I have to relearn the jungle, which I'm totally down for because I like learning new things. What can I say? I really enjoy learning new things. League of Legends, of course, a game that you haven't seen for a while now on the channel. And I can't guarantee that the return of the League of Legends content will be as hard or as heavy as it used to be. And there's a couple of real reasons why I don't do League anymore on the channel for now. And mainly, most of those go to the fact that I was having a problem with League of Legends videos getting flagged by Riot themselves here on YouTube. And I have friends who work at Riot, and I've talked to them, and none of them have seemed to have been able to help me. I'm not saying that, oh, well, they couldn't help me, so screw this game. I'm not saying anything like that. But the problem is that the problem is that it has not resolved, and YouTube continually flags my League of Legends videos to the point where I have to bring them down or unlist them. And that ends up putting strikes on my YouTube account if I'm not careful. So as a broadcaster, as a content producer, the easiest thing for me to do is just say, well, you know what, I'm just not going to play the game anymore and upload them to YouTube anyway. I'll still stream them, but I won't put them on YouTube because I don't want that to affect my YouTube stuff, especially if it gets ignored from the side of the people that can actually help me with it. I've sent in numerous emails to Riot to ask for help, to ask for assistance with the problem here on YouTube, and I have not heard anything back. And all my friends that work at Riot that I've talked to said that they'll try to see, push it along with the correct departments, and nothing has come back from that. So it's easier for me just to say, well, it's not worth the risk. I'm not gonna upload them if they jeopardize the channel in any way. So that's the real reason. Mostly the real reason why I haven't been playing League as much is because I can't. If I'm going to record them, I still can't upload them, so I'm not going to record them. I'm just going to play League on my own time. But I am looking forward to the new League of Legends season, as well as the release of Heroes of the Storm. That's going to be a big one. So that is going to be that. I don't think I have anything else that I want to talk about other than I just want to say thank you. Thank you to everyone here on YouTube. As cliche as this sounds. I do want to say thank you to everyone out there who has joined me in my journey here in 2014. It was the biggest year ever. I'm looking forward to 2015. I cannot wait to see what the future holds as far as gaming is concerned. Other shows that are going to be coming down the way here on Twitch as well. It all just revolves around with me just saying thank you. And again, I give credit where credit's due. I would not be here without Husky. And again, like I said, Husky is my brother. He's helped me throughout so much, and I've helped him as well doing some other stuff. And that's really what it comes down to, is just knowing how lucky I am. How lucky I am to have a Twitch TV channel that is partnered. How lucky I am to be able to even make a paycheck, make $1 off of YouTube. And my goals are, I'm going to be shooting for the stars, shooting for the moon, if you will, this year, in hopes that it's probably not going to happen. Financial independence on new media is extremely, extremely difficult. You have the equivalent of winning the lottery while getting stung by a bee and eaten by a shark simultaneously. That is the odds. But I've always been a fighter. I've always been someone who can definitely, I can, my reach never exceeds my grasp. Let's put it that way. I know what I'm capable of, and I have somewhat realistic goals, I think, in my mind anyway. Some people would argue that they are a little bit silly, but I would say, you know what, at least I have goals. It's important to have goals. It's important to visualize where you can be, and I think that the year of 2015 is going to be great for me. So thanks for watching, everyone. Thank you for listening. Again, I apologize that this was not recorded live on Twitch, but I did not want to skip out another show here, and I wanted to get this up on YouTube as fast as possible. I hope your New Year's was great. I hope everyone's holiday season was fantastic as well, filled with many great memories with friends, family, and loved ones. Good luck in the new year. Let me know down below, what are your goals for the year 2015? If you want to call them resolutions, please, by all means, do so. I'm not going to judge you either way. Just let me know. Again, and I want to thank each and every one of you personally, from me to you, to say thank you for supporting the content, for letting me do this as my career. If it ends up failing, hey, you know what? At least we could say we tried, and I am always, always willing to try. Thank you very much for listening, everyone. Until next time, so long, everybody.